Hello everyone. Right now, I am going to discuss some of my beliefs. As you can see, I got some of my books here. Some of these you've already seen. So somebody literally contacted me and asked me if I could do a video about my personal beliefs. So I'm just trying to set this up here. Okay, so, oh, my cat is in here, one of my cats, Cosmo. My personal beliefs are, I am a Gnostic Luciferian. Oh, it looks like both of them are in here. My cats. Okay. I am a Gnostic Luciferian. And I believe that Lucifer is a part of Sophia. Point he was incarnated on Earth. Many people call this incarnation Christ. I don't use the term Jesus. I call him Yeshua, which is the actual Hebrew pronunciation. But most of the time, I just think of him as Lucifer. My goodness, I cannot get this thing to this. So, anyway, and the magic that I practice is I practice a mixture of both. I hate to use the term black and white magic because there really is no such thing as just it's what you do with magic. Magic is, from my understanding, it depends on the intentions. But I work with both hands, which means I do both. I bless and I curse. So I will do light spells, but I will also do dark spells. I'm not afraid to punish people. In fact, I have had some obnoxious neighbors since I've moved in here. And I'm already planning on doing a little forcing them out type of thing. If you guys want, I can teach you how to make a black magic curse bag or a hex bag. It's a mojo bag, and it's black. And chicken bones in it and coffin nails, which really are not from a coffin, but they're called coffin nails. They are actually just rust nails, rusty nails, and some gopher dust, amongst other things. So most of the magic that I practice is typically folk, conjure type of stuff. I do a lot of what is often called hoodoo magic, which is associated with Afro-Caribbean faiths usually, but there are actually a lot of European people and the world that practice this very same thing. For example, gypsies often utilized hex bags also, and they also used some more fortune telling techniques, such as rather than crowley shells, they tossed coins and then read how the coins fell. I'm sorry, that's my cat. So, and they also did things with dice too. So, that's partly what hoodoo is, a mixture of African and Native American and European put together, pretty much. It is a folk magic tradition. So, whereas ceremonial magic is more, Jewish, Kabbalah based, Hermetic based. So, I was also asked my experience with infernal beings. I have corresponded with quite a few infernal beings. Currently, I am working heavily with Asmodeus. Asmodeus does not take fools lightly. So, I've been fortunate enough to win his respect. I have heard that some people do not do well with Asmodeus. He is pretty fiery. And he and I, though, have a pretty good working relationship, I think. In fact, he's the guy that's been kind of supporting me with this whole accident of my neighbors, who, when I told them the problem, they basically told me, "I don't have to kiss your ass. Fuck you." So now I have to do something about it. I have to take it into my hands. Yeah. But their television is always loud in my bedroom. And she flat out admitted that she keeps the volume to 20. Which is fucking loud, okay? Because these walls are like cardboard. So, anyway. So, that's what I have to do. Because I have a hard time fucking sleeping. but, anyway. Thank you. also worked with Farrakis. Farrakis is my guardian spirit. From the Galatia, and he's very cool guy, but he likes, well, I got in touch with these guys. I really had to sort of challenge myself, because I had to challenge some of the, my own personal beliefs and biases. I've had some ask me for animal sacrifice, for example. Which I will get into that pretty soon here. So I know that he is kind of, there are some scary things about Farrakis. What are you guys doing? For instance, he did work with the serial killer Richard Ramirez. I actually became interested in Richard Ramirez when I started working with Farrakis, and it occurred to me that he was definitely the guardian spirit of Richard Ramirez. So if you have a problem with that, you may not want to work with him. Some of these guys have worked with serial killers. Because Richard Ramirez was a Satanist. So he did work with the Infernos guys. And let me explain something to everyone here. Everybody, no matter what you believe in, has two guardian angels. One is a fallen angel, and the other is an angel from heaven. And it doesn't matter what you believe in, you can be an atheist and you will still have two angels. And so Richard Ramirez had Farrakis, and then he had one from heaven. So, and these beings, there's an old legend where it says that the one from heaven writes things down, good deeds down, and then closes the book. The one from hell keeps the book open and records everything. So it doesn't matter whether you believe in that or not. That's just something that I have been, you know, told. And you know, they've told me the same thing. It doesn't matter. People have told me the same thing. So when you get in touch with some of these guys, you're going to encounter some really like bad boys, you know, and you have to be prepared for that. I'm not saying that that's not, that, I mean, that him being with Richard Ramirez is not why Richard Ramirez killed people. Like, he killed people because he was conditioned by Michael Ramirez, who came back from Vietnam War and basically took a 12-year-old Richard Ramirez and conditioned him into breaking into houses and killing people. So it was because of how he was raised. It has nothing to do with him being involved in Satanism or any of these guys. so but you will encounter some crazy shit when you still when you start dealing with the dark side people. I mean, I've had stuff happen like you may not believe. I'm a big believer. I am not one of those Michael W. Forbes, you know, Church of Satan ripoff Luciferians. Okay, I believe 100% in the spirits. I believe in Lucifer. I believe in Sophia. You know, I despise the Demiurge. The Creator is an abomination of ours. So, and you guys can feel free to contact me on my Facebook page. I have a Facebook page called Unofficial Luciferian Light Order. And I can continue to answer questions regarding what I believe in, various magical practices. So, what else was I going to tell you? It's really hot in here right now. There's always a lot of fiery energy in my bedroom here. Because I don't have anywhere else to set these altars. Because I live in a one-bedroom apartment, so that makes it difficult. So I have a lot of fiery energy in here. I did just put an offering on the Infernal Spirit altar, which I can show you guys if you want. Oh, and this is Elsie, the skull here. She has been used in rituals. She's got that sulfur sigil on her forehead. This is my this is my pot here, my Kambanda pot. I've put more stuff in there since I first did that video. This is a drum that I use. Also got some tridents here. So yeah. So I just did an offering here of, I put some raw egg in there, and, there's some farofa, and, some chopped peppers, and, some, palm oil. So this is my fallen angel demon Ishu Pomagira altar thing. These are just different names for basically the same guys. I got that guy there. I got him recently. That big tall one there. It's got a pretty wicked grin, and he's got some red eyes. But there's Beelzebub there. This was a radio at one point. It used to be blue, but I painted the outside black because they wanted it painted black. But I got it from the antique store off of this guy, and he told me a Hispanic family was using it. So, thing of payment up here. I got this in Salem. That was pretty awesome. That store I went to in Salem. That's payment. I was going to talk to you guys about Kabanda a little bit. Yes, I do practice Kabanda, but I practice it in my own way. Traditional Kabanda people do not typically syncretize the Goetia spirits with the Ishus and Momagers. And there's an avenging angel looking one. He's got a goat head in his hand. I don't think you can see that, but so this one's two headed one. So, and this is my Asmodeus Asia Rider. Asmodeus is the king, and so I attributed him to Ishuri. Now, the traditional Kabandist is going to be like, well, wait a minute, that's disrespectful and all that, blah, blah, blah. But here's the thing. The thing that got me into Kabanda was Jake Stratton Kent's True Grimoire. And, ever since I've read that, I started getting into it, because what he did was he actually, compared to, in the last chapter, he compares, the demons in the Grimoire Verum, the True Grimoire, with, the Kabanda entities. So that was my go-to book in the beginning for that. So that's why I syncretize these guys. because that was revealed to me through that source, but also from other sources too. Contrary to popular belief, you do not have to speak Portuguese to address these guys. If that is your belief, you are more than welcome to speak Portuguese to address these guys. But I think they would much rather you, spoke in whatever language you were born. Your native language. For me, obviously, that's English. See, I have a Samael. It's another Samael. It's a throne there. So I can discuss more about Kamanda. I did a ritual with someone for Bozipop recently, and I had to pay him back because he kind of helped me. I made a pact with some of these guys to help me move, and while I'm not crazy about Maryland, I have to say, nevertheless, I still had to pay him back. So, I know it's going to upset some of my subscribers when I post this ritual, because it does feature chicken sacrifice. So, I know that there are subscribers that are 100% plant-based, you know, vegan. But just because you're a vegan and the guy that did it actually, that I worked with, he himself is vegan. And he still sacrifices animals to them because he understands that that's what they like. Just because you have a dietary preference doesn't mean these guys are going to have that dietary preference. And whatever bullshit you tell yourself as a European person, that because you're European, you don't have to sacrifice animals, that's total nonsense, people. You know, they don't care, man. The issues are not going to care what your nationality is. They're going to demand the same stuff from you as much as they demand from somebody that is black, somebody that is Brazilian, native Brazilian and stuff. They're gonna say the same thing. It doesn't matter. And I have heard that bullshit claim, man, from some YouTubers. Well, I'm European, so I don't have to sacrifice animals and stuff. They don't fucking care, man. These guys, man, they will ask you for it. You know, they are harsh. So, I will tell you right now, if you have problems with it, and I do myself have problems with it because I'm actually in Morris, do not get involved in Kamanda. Do not even talk to these guys. Like, seriously, these spirits, they will get on you about things. You know, I don't eat beef, but I bought a steak, a raw steak, one day for Bullseybub, because I wanted to let him know that I was ready and willing to work with this guy. So I had to step out of my boundaries, out of my comfort zone, to work with this bad guy, this badasser. Because he is, he's a total badass. And I actually have a statue of Belphegor there, which is another form of Bullseybub, Ball of Pure. So, I have two statues of Bullseybub there. So, my advice is do your homework before you work with these guys. Now, on the other hand, visit Lucifer again. This is my Lucifer altar. So I have a Dembala Busa Basal thing. There's a Drapo. If voodoo flag thing. Because I heard Vera missed in Bala. I painted this. The overall thing here. Just kind of shut that off. So, Lucifer does not want animal sacrifice. He is not interested in meat offerings. He is probably the most vegan-friendly deity on the block. This guy is, like, he is amazing. And I have multiple images of him from different cultures on here because I practice syncretism, which is, taking various masks. Michael Ford talks about the same thing. He calls it Mask of the Adversary. There's that there. And then I got Sophia in the back there. Got Mary Magdalene there. His wife. This is a female consort. And he's got a little mandarin orange there. He likes fruit. He likes sweets. So anyway. My cats are trying to get out. Hey Cosmo. Say hi. Alright, so I'm going to wrap it up now. I just thought I'd kind of explain some of my beliefs. Like I said, you can hit me up on that Facebook page that I have. Unofficial Luciferian Light Order. If you have more questions, I will try to do more videos. No, that's bad, Jerry. Jerry. Can't knock over stuff. You smart ass. Yeah. So anyway, if you did enjoy this video, please hit like and subscribe. Thank you.